tell me who your character is in this film.
General Sikorsky, commander of the Soviet sector of the occupied Berlin 1945.
And what exactly is it like working on a Steven Soderbergh set?
Magic. It's delightful. It's so easy. And it's fascinating to watch his mind travel places. And this is the most mesmerizing thing, actually, watching Steven work. Because, as you must know, he's involved, starts from writing, a real auteur movie maker, from writing to camera to directing to editing, everything. So you can see how the story gets edited in his mind, and it's like, it's great to see. It's wonderful.
Does it make it easier for you as an actor when you come onto a set like that?
Oh, yes, it certainly makes it more exciting, and you kind of try to catch his wave and click in, and when it happens, you kind of both acknowledge that and recognize that, and that's when you start riding the wave. It's surfing.
And just in a nutshell, what exactly is the story of The Good German?
Well, I'm told I can't give away too much.
Yeah, that's right. You can't, so what can you
but
do?
It's an espionage story with romance and murder and thriller, all set in occupied Berlin of 1945.
Wow, that's amazing. Why do you think audiences are so in love again with black and white movies and accepting film noir?
My first experience, you know, when you watch it on TV, it's not the same. The first time I saw Casablanca ever was in London in Illusion Theatre, that is no longer, and it sucks you into a different world. You kind of live in a different dimensions, and the black and white becomes acceptable after a while, and the shape of things start playing tricks on your mind, because color differentiates and black and white kind of connects, so it becomes the three-dimensional thing becomes more obvious. The lighting becomes so important, and the actors look great in black and white films. You know, the makeup and stuff. Yeah.